Hello, I'm Chris Menard. If you use polling in Zoom, you're going to love the new update that they rolled out with in April of 2022. Let's go ahead and dive into this really cool feature. So Zoom polling has been around for a long time. You've got two types of meetings. You got a meeting using your personal meeting ID, PMI, and you have meetings where you don't use your personal meeting ID. I may refer to those as dynamic meetings. Every time you have one, it changes. Your personal meeting ID stays constant. It's always been easy to sign into Zoom.us and go to your personal room. So this is your personal meeting ID, and go to polls and quizzes and set these questions up. But most meetings do not involve your personal meeting ID. So out in April of 2022, Zoom 5.10.3. You can now have a library or a bank of polls and quizzes, and they're always available for you if you want them to. I've already made up three polls over here. I do want to enable them. That is going to mean they're going to be available whenever I have a meeting. Doesn't matter what kind of meeting, I'm going to see these three questions. I'm going to add one more just to cover this. So if I go to create, polls have been around forever. They recently came out with these advanced polls and quizzes. I have a video detailing all the different question types. In case you're wondering, if I go to polls, this will be real quick. I've got single choice or multiple choice. I'm going to have single choice and multiple choice in the advanced also, but I have no option here to make these a drop down or to make these required. So I'm going to cancel. So if I go to create advanced, I've got six options, and that's the video again down below that I just showed you. I've got matching, rank order, short and long answer, but they're still single choice and multiple choice. But I can do a drop down and I can make this required. I'm going to make this up and I'm going to call this remote work. You can have multiple questions. Do you enjoy working remotely? That's the question. Single choice. I'm going to keep this really simple and make it yes or no. Yes, no. I could add more questions about working remotely, but I'm going to hit save. When I hit save, I now have four polls that can have multiple questions. Enabled is available for all of them. So every meeting I start, I'm going to have these four for sure. Let's go and test this right now. I'm going to go pull up Zoom on the desktop. This works on the PC and it works on the Mac, but you've got to have 5.10.3. Currently, 5.10.4 is out, so I do. We pull up Zoom. So I've got Zoom running. Click on your initials or your profile picture and hit check for updates. And there you go right there. Close. I'm going to start there's my personal meeting ID. Notice it's not checked. So when I start this meeting, it's a dynamic meeting ID. I've got this meeting started. There's polls. We know I should have four different polls. Let's see if that's true. There's that remote work that I did that had one question. If I click on it right there, do you enjoy working remotely? So every meeting I start, I will always have this bank or library of poll questions. This is such a cool feature. Here's another cool feature about it. I'm in this meeting right now. Pop back to Zoom.us. Create. I am making this up. Test. Test. I don't care about the answers. I'm going to hit save. Watch this. Back to Zoom on the desktop. My meeting is actually still going. Polls. There's that test I just added. So even if you go during a meeting and pop back into Zoom.us and say, oh, I need to go add some more questions, just go add them and they're available in your meeting. Really, really cool feature. Let me know if you like this feature. Feel free to subscribe and ring the bell. Have a great day. Thank you.